Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Peace and blessings of Allah be upon each and every one of you today. And the topic at hand today is going to be what the Orientalists and a lot of Christian evangelists are saying about the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's marriage to Aisha radiallahu anha. They were making some, you know, insinuation that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam married, you know, Aisha at the age of 9, some say at the age of 10, some even say 6. But what we need to understand based upon this sort of arrangement back then in the 7th century is that we have culture, and then we have tradition, and we have environment, and we have years that have passed away. Do you know that today, as we sit here right now, in Mongolia, in India, and in some part of our Asianic countries, and even South America, people still do this kind of marriage? But the purpose of this kind of marriage is to establish cordial relationship, is to establish, you know, a peace, is to establish, you know, a oneness in the community, and to, you know, diffuse any sort of eventualities of war. And that was exactly what the Messenger of Allah did. But actually, I believe, and most of the scholars believe, that the marriage was made around 10, 9 years. Okay, fine. But that was at the very beginning of the Messenger of Allah's mission, when he received the Nubuwa. And this marriage took place. It did take place. But what I'm concerned is this. Those who are making this kind of statement based upon this kind of marriage, they're even making fun of it. They even call the Messenger of Allah a certain name that I can't even mention. They should also understand that the consummation did not take place until many, many, many years. Because after the marriage, the Messenger stayed, you know, in Mecca for the next 8 years. Okay, let's put it this way. So she was, let's say she was 9 years plus 8. That would be what, 17 years? And then he left Mecca to Medina, and she was still playing with her friends, you know, outside in the sun. And the consummation did not take place. It took place about 7-8 years after the Messenger, you know, relocated to Medina. So all these things, they don't look at this angle. They only look at the, you know, that you know, hate and that kind of whatever they have in mind that they want to say about this kind of marriage. That's what they say, and without looking at the background. And we also know that in England, that there was a time that kings and monarchs were marrying, you know, ladies at the age of 8, at the age of 9, at the age of 10. That was the order of the day. But the consummation don't take place. There was no consummation at all. Like I said, in India and Mongolia, people still do this kind of marriage, but there was no consummation. The consummation comes, you know, when, you know, she went through her first puberty, and then again a few years, then there's consummation. And also understand that the father of Aisha, Abu Bakr Siddiq, he see fit to allow that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam marry his daughter at the age of 9. Fine, that was the order of the day. The enemies in Mecca never for once in any historical reference made a statement and say, okay, Muhammad have married at the age of this and that, so we have to make noise and let everybody know. They didn't do that because it is the order of the day. None of those who live in Mecca or Medina at the time of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam raise a finger and point to Muhammad that he did this kind of marriage, because they know that the consummation takes many, many years. It takes a lot of years before there was a consummation. If the age of marriage was 9, fine. But the consummation could be when she reached maybe 18, 19, and 20. You know, and today, how many women do we have in the world today? How many women do we have in the world that if all men should get married, they wouldn't get anyone to marry them? How many? You know very well that I know very well. According to the Pew Foundation and the Helena Rubinstein Foundation, if all men in America marry, there would be 7.5 million other women who have no marriage. The same thing is true in England, in Germany, in France, all the Western part of the world. Who's going to marry them? And you know, if there are so many women in the world, it's going to be a lot of chaos. It causes a lot of problems. There's going to be a lot of disco. There's going to be a lot of promiscuity. And there's going to be a lot of prostitution. There's going to be a lot of things that is not good. Even the book of Isaiah mentioned that, you know, towards the end of time, it's going to be a time that each and every man will have to marry 7 women. Yet, we can't fulfill, you know, to marry all the women at that time. So all these things are, you know, tell tales that Allah in His wisdom, He knows that there's going to be a lot of women. So He allowed this kind of marriage to take place. Okay, this is going to be the part one. I'm just sweeping the ground. I'm just laying down the foundation. Inshallah, tomorrow, I'm going to send down the part two. That's when I'm going to delve deep into the marriage of Aisha radiallahu anha. Hazza billahi tawfiq. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.